Hey guys, and welcome to the next part of our Villa Intercom series. And today we'll be setting up one door station and now we'll be attaching two screens to it. Okay, so obviously when the doorbell rings, both screens should ring, and we call the second screen an extension screen. Okay, so as you see right now, we've added it with another blue cable just to make life easier. But we do have two different times here, which is a bit weird because we've activated the devices. That's all we've done, guys. We haven't set a timer or anything like that, or even linked the door station. Yeah, calling fail, the words you don't want to hear. So we're going to go over now to IVMS and set them up, and hopefully we get a time that's synced as well and everything should be working smoothly. Catch you in a sec. All right, guys, we're on IVMS now, and let's jump straight into it and go straight to our door station. Okay, so this setup I've already done before in a previous video, at least with the without the extension screen. So if you did want to add an extension, you just set it up the normal way and then add an extension afterwards. Okay, guys, it's pretty linear in that way. Okay, so let's just set it up like normal. And while I'm setting it up, because I've already explained all of this, I'll just give you some tips for using IVMS for a while and setting up intercoms, is that I definitely would make sure you've got a recent laptop or PC, okay, if you're going to be doing this. So it's very important that you keep your PC updated with the latest software and things like that. And all those boring Windows updates that you have to do, unfortunately, guys, I would recommend doing that. I mean, you don't need anything special, you know, no high processing power or anything like that, not lots of memory or storage. But you will need, you know, something quite modern, I would say, because I've used old PCs before setting up on other people's systems and it can be very buggy. All right, guys, and yeah, it's a long time doing those updates and things if you're on site, so I would say get something that's pretty modern, pretty up to date. Okay, so as you see, our indoor station is offline, and let's go ahead and go to that and sort it out. So what I'm going to do, guys, as well, is take the time for the NTP site and put it onto our system, because you see when we set up the extension, we're going to have to put that in again. Okay, so this is all ready to go. That looks good, the time. I think they've taken it over from it actually should be March, isn't it? Last Sunday at 1, but the NTP stuff has been taken over from before. And now we go to intercom and we're going to link our door station. Okay, so you see it's already got the main door station IP. All you have to do is put in the password and it should be connected. Okay, so to check without ringing it, it should get registered now. Oh no, it still says offline. Okay, what's gone wrong here? Let's go back to our screen. Maybe put the password in wrong. Okay, let's try again. So our door station now should be configured. Yeah, now it says online. All right, so that should work. Now we're gonna go ahead and add the extension to the main screen. So we go to our main screen. This is where we add the extension, guys, all right? So we go to network. No, we go to intercom, and then we go to extension, and then we go add. Okay, so we got all our information for our extension screen here, our IP address, our gateway, serial number, all this stuff. Okay. And it'll be number one. Even though it's the second screen, it's the first extension. Okay, so if you add another extension, that'll be extension number two. So okay, that's unregistered, just like before. We have to go to our extension to link it together. Okay, so our extension's here. And normal, guys, don't forget, the first thing you have to do is set the time. And we're going to do NTP, and this is why we saved the information earlier. Set it to one, so just hopefully to get it to work. Okay, that's saved now, and now we go to intercom. Oh, sorry, we go to network and we go to group network settings. As you see here, it still thinks it's an indoor station. Even though the other screen is looking for an extension, The extension doesn't exist until we make an extension. And we make this number one, just the same number as we named it before. So we click on save and it should close automatically. That means it's kind of rebooting, doing whatever it has to do, but we still have to go back to it again, guys. Don't forget to go back to it again. And now when we go to network and group network settings, we're gonna have, it's gonna be an extension and it's looking for the main indoor station IP. So that's your main screen IP. So whenever you add an extension, it's always gonna be looking for this number. Okay, so we go to main screen, put our IP there and the password. There we go, save. Now that should all be linked up together nicely, but we're just gonna check on the main screen that it has registered. So then we go to Intercom extension settings, registered. Okay, so everything looks good now. Just go to the live view, test it out, and hopefully it all syncs up. Catch you in a sec. So back to the live view now. Let's ring the bell first of all, test it out. Perfect, both of them ringing at the same time. Let's hang that up. Okay, now the only thing I'm concerned about, oh, the time, it just literally both changed simultaneously. That means the time has also been set correctly, as it should, guys. So that's the setup done for this video, and the next video we'll be doing the same setup, but the extension screen will be using Wi-Fi and not a cable for the data, but you will have to obviously power it. So stay tuned for that if you're interested, and more coming up soon. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.